In the Game of Thrones finale, Brienne filled out the rest of Sir Jaime Lannister's pages in the White Book, the Book of Brothers. Here's his page from back in the day when Joffrey mocked him.
Someone forgot to write down all your great deeds.
Here's his page now. As you can see, they're different, so what's up? Is this a new book? Did it burn? Technically, it could be a new book. Maybe the head scribes periodically make copies of it stored down at the Citadel or something like that. But I don't think so. What I think happened is that the showrunner simply changed Jaime Lannister's entry to add some color to Jaime Lannister's character.
If it weren't for you, I never would have survived my childhood. You would have.
So, the Lord Commander fills out the pages, right? Which means that there's going to be different types of handwriting. Sir Gerald Hightower, he should have written this part before Robert's Rebellion. And then Sir Barristan should have added in this part about Jaime becoming known as the Kingslayer after Robert's Rebellion. In the books, Jaime then adds in a section of his own, and it's pretty important. He writes it sloppily with his left hand, quote, "Defeated in the Whispering Wood by the Young Wolf, Robb Stark, during the War of the Five Kings, held captive at River Run and ransomed for a promise unfulfilled. Captured again by the brave companions and maimed at the word of Vargo Hoth, their captain, losing his sword hand to the blade of Zolo the Fat, returned safely to King's Landing by Brienne, the Maid of Tarth." The two key takeaways are that Jaime highlights how he was ransomed for a promise unfulfilled, which shows how guilty he was of not being able to honor his oath to Lady Cat, to return the Stark Girls to her unharmed, despite having been forced to swear those oaths while dead drunk, chained up to a wall with a sword pressed to his chest. The second key takeaway to Jaime's addition in the books is that Jaime gives credit to Brienne for getting him back to King's Landing safely when she didn't. She failed. But Jaime was Lord Commander, so he got to choose what was written into that book, and Jaime chose words that reflected highly on Brienne. The show version of Jaime is a little darker than book Jaime, so the show version does not deny Cersei. He has sex with her in the White Sword Tower, big no-no. And in the show version, Brienne names the sword Oathkeeper instead of Jaime naming it like he does in the books. So the show version of Jaime is a little darker, but this edited entry, it sheds new light on who Jaime is, on who show Jaime is. Because there are two sets of handwriting here, one of which has to be Jaime's. Technically, there should be three here. Sir Geralt's entry, Sir Barristan's entry, and then Sir Jaime's, but it looks like there's just two. The second bit of handwriting has to be Jaime's because it mentions Joffrey's death, and that comes after Sir Barristan left the Kingsguard. So that means that Jaime himself highlighted that he became known as the Kingslayer. That might not seem like that big a deal, but trust me, it's huge. That word, Kingslayer, it's a trigger word for Jaime. That word takes him to a very dark place whenever he hears it, so the fact that show Jaime wrote that about himself, it says a lot about who Jaime really is. He's not that different from book Jaime. He was a true knight, or at least someone who expected more from himself. Someone who had a deep-seated desire to do better. And he did. Like Brim points out, Jaime took River Run from the Tully rebels without loss of life. He lured the Unsullied into attacking Castle Rock, sacrificing his childhood home in service to a greater strategy. He outwitted the Targaryen forces to seize Highgarden and fought at the Battle of the Gold Road bravely, narrowly escaping death by dragonfire. He pledged himself to the forces of men and rode north to join them at Winterfell, alone. He faced the army of the dead and fended the castle against impossible odds until the defeat of the Night King.
Come on!
He escaped imprisonment and rode south in an attempt to save the capital from destruction. Sir Jaime Lannister died protecting his queen. It is the duty of the Lord Commander to keep the entries up to date. The words that Brienne chose will shape how the world remembers Jaime Lannister. And the fact that she, of all people, chose those specific words should shape how we as fans remember her.